Let's now start the installation of WordPress by using Docker. And for that, I will open the terminal. And as you see here, so I can create a new terminal by clicking here. Now I have an access to the virtual machine, Ubuntu server. Now, if I do an ls, you will see all of the files, Docker Compose and README. But I need to create two other folders. These two folders are a WordPress folder. It will be needed in order to mount this var.wwhtml from the Gatsby WordPress container into the WordPress folder. I'll just create one, create a new folder, and I'll go for WordPress. And for the second folder, it will be Docker. Why? Because it will mount the data from this var.lib MySQL into a Docker folder. I will create a new folder, Docker. Our Docker Compose file is ready to be used. Then we'll need to use Docker Compose command. So in order to install the container from the images. Okay, for that, I will run Docker Compose app from the terminal. And just be sure that you are inside the project because you need this Docker Compose file right here. Okay, let's just rerun the command, Docker Compose and app. What this Docker Compose app will do exactly is just go to each image first. So this is MySQL and phpMyAdmin and the third image, which is WordPress, and download them. Then it will create three containers. First container is Gatsby MySQL. The second one is Gatsby phpMyAdmin. And the third one is Gatsby WordPress. And it will do all of the configuration and apply them. Hit enter to run the command. And as you see here, I have created Gatsby MySQL. So these are the containers that are created. Okay, let's just go to the top a little bit. And this is what do I have a result. Creating Gatsby WordPress and creating Gatsby phpMyAdmin. So the Docker Compose app doesn't go to download the images because I already have these images already downloaded in my virtual machine. Okay, to check that, I use this extension right here, Docker. It's already connected to this virtual machine right here. And as you see here, I have three images. This one, which is WordPress, MySQL, and phpMyAdmin. These are the ones that I'm using here from the Docker Compose in order to create the containers. And at the end, if we take a look here, so this is the process is finishing. I have all of the containers created and they are run. And if we take a look here, I have three containers ready to be used. This is the first one, which is, okay, let's just increase the size a little bit. So I have Gatsby phpMyAdmin created app. And app means that it is up to be used. And I have also Gatsby WordPress and Gatsby MySQL. If you remember that I created a Docker folder and a WordPress folder, okay, let's just check that. I have a WordPress folder and Docker folder. Now, if I open them, you will see that there are some files mounted inside this WordPress folder. It was empty, but now it just get into this var.wwhtml from the container Gatsby WordPress and put all of the files. It's just mounting them. It's not copying them, but mounting them inside this WordPress folder. Same for the Docker folder. We will have some files and folders within. And the files and folders are from this var.lib MySQL from the Gatsby MySQL container. For example, if you want to take a look to this var.wwhtml right here, we have two ways to do that. Let's just open the SSH and go here and I will run use Docker run, then sorry, use Docker exec, then IT option. Then I will use the name of the container, which is Gatsby WordPress. Now I'm trying just to access to this container files. I'll use bin bash. Okay, I'm just executing bin bash from the Gatsby WordPress container to access to the bash. Okay, now I just have access to the container and this is the folder var.wwhtml and this is this one, var.wwhtml. Then if I do an ls, you will see all of the files that are mounted within this WordPress folder on my project. If you don't want to do it manually by running this Docker exec IT, you can just go here to the extension right here, Docker, and right click on the WordPress container so you can stop the container or attach the shell to run the bin bash. Now, if I just click here, you will see that it created a new shell here and I just access to this var.wwhtml from the container without running the Docker exec manually. Okay, let's just close all of that and return to the shell and do an ls. Now, how to access to, for example, phpMyAdmin before we install WordPress. And to access to phpMyAdmin, you need to use this port 8086. But you need first to know the IP address of the virtual machine. Okay, I will do if config grep 192. And this is the IP address. Okay, I will just copy this IP address and use the port 8086. Okay, let's just move to the browser and I'll copy the IP address and use 8086 and Voila, so I can access the phpMyAdmin. If, for example, you want to use localhost instead of this IP address, and for that, let's just move to the Visual Studio Code and create and click on this remote SSH extension. And we have here an option to use forwarded ports. And for that, just click here and forward the port 8086 from the virtual machine into your local machine. So I'm just using forwarded 8086. Now I can access to the localhost instead of, let's just access to them both. Okay, I'll just copy that, and instead of the IP address, I'll use localhost and hit enter, and voila. So we can access the phpMyAdmin from the localhost and also from the IP address. Let's do the same thing for the Gatsby WordPress container, and we'll just forward this port 8000 to 8000 to use it locally. Now I can access this 8000 by using the localhost address. Okay, now localhost and 8000. And we can start installing WordPress. And if we take a look here, so this is just accessing to the Gatsby WordPress. So this 8000 is to access to Gatsby WordPress container. Now we can run the installation WordPress. Let's just go for Gatsby WordPress and username. Let's just use Gatsby. Password, use Gatsby. Sorry, I'm using a weak password. And let's just use my email at gl.com. And install WordPress and log in Gatsby and cool. So WordPress is installed and ready to be used. If you struggle doing this configuration, just leave me a comment and I will be happy to answer. Otherwise, you can download WordPress manually from wordpress.org, then install it by using a software like Map or XAMPP to install it.